Are you in a place with your partner where you feel like you are just at the end of your rope and you feel like you don't know if the two of you are gonna make it? If this is the case, I am talking to you today, and I wanna give you one super important reality check to do with yourself to find out if this particular thing I'm talking about today is really impacting and killing your relationship. My name is Jacqueline Foster. I am the author of I Touch Myself, Lessons to Wake Up Desire and Fire Up Your Sex Drive. And this channel is about providing you with permission and how-to tips to both communicate and live out your desires and keep yourself in a relationship where you're feeling strong and connected and like you're growing together. So, like a year ago, my partner and I sat down and we were in a really, really tough position. I had spent about like 2 years basically wanting to help him be better. I was giving him lots of suggestions. I was telling him a lot of things that would be good for him to do, things that would help him live a healthier life and a stronger life. And really what I was doing was I was nagging the shit out of him. And we got to this point where we were kind of 2 years into me doing that. Of course, I said at the time I had good intentions. I wanted him to be healthy. I wanted him to be well. But all that came out in was directing him to be better, criticizing him, and nagging him on his choices. And we were at a breaking point. He was exhausted. I was exhausted because it was just a battle. And he was just so sick of being told what to do and suggested what would be right for him. And I read in a book actually from this woman, Pat Allen, something she said that changed my life. She said, "You don't have nagging rights, you have leaving rights." And I was a huge holy shit moment for me where I realized, oh my gosh, if I want to be with this person, I have to stop nagging. I have to look within myself and I have to change what I'm doing. And so my question to you is to really tune into whether or not nagging is a part of your relationship, really something that you do to your partner or that you feel like your partner does to you. It's really important to notice this because nagging is one of the worst things that we can do to create connection with ourselves and with our partner. And what I've found for myself, and I think this is pretty common for people, is that when we want to change something within ourselves, it can be really hard, and it can be a lot easier to focus on what other people are doing wrong instead of what we need for ourselves to grow. And so one of the best things we can do to redirect our energy from nagging and helping is to start to focus on what we want to do as individuals to grow. It is such a powerful and amazing thing to continue to check in on what we can do for ourselves to grow and show up as better partners, as better people in the world, with, you know, like allowing ourselves to really connect with what gives us meaning and purpose and really like kind of untangling what we need to live that person and live to be that person we want to be on the greatest way possible. So check in with yourself on this. My challenge to you is to really get honest and real with yourself about whether or not you are bringing nagging and criticism to your relationship, whether you're trying to be a helper. That's what I thought I was a helper. So asking yourself if that's something that you're doing, and if it is, to start to come clean with yourself on the fact that you're doing it and start to ask yourself, hey, like, how do I want to be better? How do I want to show up differently? And instead of putting your focus on helping your partner, help yourself. Focus on being a better person for yourself and a better person for your partner. I have noticed huge changes from this. It's not always easy. I have helper relapses at times. This is normal. But when we start to change our focus and our energy, everything can change. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to this channel. Also make sure to come on over to JacquelineLaceyFoster.com where you can pop in your email so that you can get updates and information posts I don't always post here on YouTube. Wishing you an amazing day. Keep your desire alive and I'll see you next time.